auditorium looks beautiful.
Amen.
Yeah. Do you agree with me? Not necessarily the wall. I'm talking about the people in the auditorium. How many of you agree that we are looking beautiful?
Amen.
Now, we're going to do something. Do you know that there are some women in this hall who took time to dress up?
Yes.
They took time to make up. It will be very, very wrong of us, guys, men, if we don't appreciate the time and effort they took to dress up. So pretty soon, we are going to begin to go around and appreciate women especially. You know they are the salt of the earth. You know that. So get ready to do that. But before we do that, let's appreciate some people quickly. Let's put our hands together as we appreciate the presence of God, the Father, and Jesus, and the Holy Ghost in this place. It is because of them that we are here. So let's put that. You're appreciating God now, you're not appreciating me. Is that the way you appreciate your God? I mean, you should clap like you're born again. Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ, for his death on the cross. And you are sitting down, clapping for Jesus Christ, who died for you on the cross. He is the one that left his throne and came and died for you on the cross. Hallelujah. It is because of him that we are here. Praise the name of the Lord. If it was not for what he did 2,000 years ago, we would not be here. Some of us would be in the nightclub. Today is Saturday night. You know what we used to do Saturday night? Let's put that together for Jesus one more time. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. You may please take your seat. Quickly, I want to appreciate some very, very important people. And please help me to put your hands together for them, because even if you don't like their face, like their position. What did I say? Hello? Even if you don't like their face, like the position. Praise the name of the Lord. Let's put the hands together.
I appreciate you all, and I pray that things of celebration will never leave your tabernacle in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Beloved brethren and distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you to this great occasion of the 16th anniversary of Throne of Grace. The Throne of Grace of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, as we all know, is one of the parishes of the RCCG in Windsor, the mother parish, and we are privileged. We have two other parishes, the Restoration Hours by Pastor Ezra. Pastor Ezra, please let's give a clap offering to the Lord. Pastor Tunde or Pastor Tunde, you missed out something. Let's give a clap offering to the Lord for our honorable Pastor Ezra. Praise the Lord and the wife. God bless you, Sister Fumi. God bless you all for coming, and we appreciate you all. And Abdulon Parish by Pastor Balogo and the wife. As we look back to the inception of TOG 16 years ago, we can only but give unlimited thanks and praises to the Almighty God, who has continuously blessed us upon, put his blessings upon this church. You know, when I look back at everything, there was something Pastor Bauer was always saying. He said, beam the light. Beam the light. And that is what we are doing in this church. We are trying to beam the light of Jesus, the love of Jesus. And that is it. We accommodate everyone into this house. And we are just here to support people, to show the love of Jesus, and to preach the gospel. Of course, that's the major thing. That's the tool in which we use, you know, in reaching out to the lost. And that is what we have in Matthew chapter 16, verse 18. The word of God says, God will build his church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail over the church. So in spite of all the challenges, just as any other church has, we have moved forward. We have moved forward.
Amen.
We have moved forward. Now, there was something Pastor Larry said that touched me the day I met him. I said, Pastor Larry, do you know it's so difficult to follow up people, and sometimes out of nowhere, people coming to church will just disappear. You follow them up. He said, just know that the church is like a transit bus.
Yeah.
For every bus stop, people come down and some other people come up.
Yeah.
So once you have that mind, the period you are in the bus, show your love. Do everything.
Yeah.
So that even when they leave, they will remember you for those good things.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That was a word of wisdom. In fact, it gave me a peace. gave me a peace. Thank you so much, Pastor Larry, for that. True to the word of God and the vision and mission of this great ministry, to accelerate destinies, change circumstances, and transform lives, consistently, TOG preaches the undiluted word of God. She touches life with her love, and we influence people, you know, positively, so that wherever they go, that testimony is that even our children, when they go to Calgary, Edmonton, everywhere they go, they remember TOG and just say, look, this is a family. And that's what they are trying to portray wherever they go, that we were together as a family, and that family culture is being maintained wherever they go. So we give glory to God for that good influence we're giving to whoever came through this place. And moving on, you know, this is just a transit for some people. But the aim is that whatever you receive in this place, pass it on wherever you go. And God will bless you in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. The theme of this month and the theme of this assistant anniversary is divine encounter. Divine encounter. What an awesome word the Lord gave to us. And you know, in encounters, it's a sudden meeting that brings about a change, that brings about an impartation, that brings about transformation. And you see, the greatest encounter you have is with the Lord Jesus. That brings about a turnaround in your life. It takes you from a mess and makes a miracle in your life. It takes you from the miracle and sets your feet on the solid rock. It takes you from an ugly situation and beautify your life. It takes you from death condemnation and gives you eternal life. That is the greatest encounter. And it is my prayer, as many that do not have a relationship with me, think about it. Think about it. It's a time for you to have an encounter with the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Ancient of Days, the Lion of the Tribe of Judah, the Unchangeable Changer. It is a time for you to make him the Lord and Savior of your life.
Amen.
Because when he comes into your life, your life will never remain the same. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Do I have living people in this place? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord. So we have in the Bible a lot of examples of people who had divine encounters, like Abraham. Obedience is one of the watchwords for you to have an encounter. You must obey God. Praise the Lord. And you know, one thing about divine encounters is that it brings about blessings. And sometimes some encounters brings about correction. Sometimes some of them brings about demotion. And we know that if we are going on the wrong target, God in his infinite mercy, like the case of Jonah, we encounter also that we come back to our senses.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I had a good amen there.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So we are grateful to God that the encounters we are going to have, even this time, will take us to the next level.
Amen.
Do you receive that?
Amen.
I want you to tell the Lord, Father, help me.
Father.
Repeat after me, Father, help me.
Father, help me.
That the encounters I will have
will
take me to the next level. Will take me to the next level. It doesn't matter whatever Satan is doing. I know one encounter with God brings about every shame, every disgrace to nothing in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It catapults you just as it did to Abraham. It catapults you to the next height in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It separates you out in ministry in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It brings about promotion and favor in your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And that is what I want you to receive. You know, when the worst comes, it might be in drama, it might be anything. God is continuously speaking to us.
Amen.
Yes.
And I pray we will receive it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Divine encounters can also be experienced when we desire. You have to pray. I know Jacob was tired of the life he was living. And he prayed. And God met him. So sometimes some encounters, apart from the sovereignty of God, when he meets you, sometimes you have to pray for it. And God meets you at the points of your need. And I pray that someone today will touch the hem of Jesus coming.
Amen.
Someone today will touch the hem of Jesus coming.
Amen.
That every mystery in your life, every challenge in your life, everything that has brought about disgrace in your life will be turned around in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. You receive encounters when you have faith in God.
Yes.
By faith we receive. You must be a true worshiper.
Yes.
Jesus wants those who will worship in spirit and in truth. The woman of Samaria had an encounter.
Yes.
Though she was confused, but Jesus told her, the Father seeks those who will worship in spirit and in truth. And it brought an end to mystery in that woman. And I know someone will be touched today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. The gathering man had an encounter that turned his life around. Because of that encounter he had with Jesus, remember, he worshipped. Because of that encounter, he became an evangelist. It brought an end to addiction. It brought an end to mystery. It brought an end to a grave situation.
Yes.
It turned him around to become a light.
Yes.
To shine the light of Jesus everywhere. Thanks once more for coming to celebrate with TOG, the 16th anniversary.
Woo!
It is my prayer that this celebration of good things we never cease. The celebration of good things will never cease in your homes in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Once more, I thank also some of our members. They came from Toronto, Fort McMurray. You can see it from the Detroit, from Cincinnati. So many places. What an awesome family we have. They came to celebrate. And well wishes around, even in Windsor, in Toronto, you all came to celebrate the 16th anniversary with this great mission, with this great ministry. Once more, I salute you all. Thank you for coming and have a wonderful day.
You see, I know that the anointing of God can do many things. But you see, the anointing of God can't force you to smile. If you don't want to smile, you will not smile. If you don't want to clap, you will not clap. If you don't want to respond, you will not respond. Now, you see, in the house of God, everybody have their own roles and responsibility. The MC has his own role. If he plays his role well, which is to make everyone lively, but the congregation decide not to be lively, all of us, we go home unhappy. God will see me here. But all of us, we go home unhappy. So, I'm going to play my role. Tap your neighbor, say, play your role. Say it like an evangelist, say, play your role. So, when I crack a joke, or I say something and it's not even funny, that is me not playing my own role well. But you play your role well. Tap your neighbor, say, play your role. One of your role is to appreciate the person sitting beside you. Look at that person, tell them, I like your teeth. No. You're not saying it very well. Say, I like your hair. I like your eyes. Your shoe. My God, you smell great. Uh-huh, you guys are playing your role now. Now I'm feeling anointed. Now I feel anointed. Praise the name of God. Let's put our hands together for ourselves. Hallelujah. We had a wonderful program yesterday night and there were two girls. I don't know who they are. I've never met them before, but I noticed them from where I was seated. How many of us noticed on the screen? Two girls that were just dancing in beats. And when the beat was okay, they would dance with the beat. And they also dance out of the beat. But they didn't care. They were just dancing. You see, sometimes when you see some of us who decide to be unnecessarily happy in the house of God, don't blame us. You don't know where we are coming from. You don't know what we are being through. Tap your neighbor, say, play your role. You see, because sometimes some people are too stiff, and because they are stiff, other people want to rejoice. Why might? No, you are not. If you want to rejoice, you are not the one that has a problem. It is the other person, not you. Because in the house of God, there is what? No. There is fullness. Together for the drama group. Play your role. Thank you.
this has been a wonderful week.
Yes.
A wonderful 7 days.
Oh yes, we had such a lovely time.
So much wine.
Your riches were in display.
So much women.
Yes, we had such a lovely time.
You will live forever, my king.
Yes.
You are the one and only king in the whole wide
yes.
world. Like
yes.
Your Majesty, you need to sit down.
Yes.
You've had such a lovely time in 7 days.
We need to do this more often.
Yes.
Every day.
We need to buy more wine.
Yes.
And get the finest ladies.
In the whole world.
In the whole world.
Yes.
And invite all the other kings.
Yes.
Let's go.
Long live my king.
Thank you. Where is Vashti, my wife?
You want to see Vashti?
Yes, I want to see Vashti, the queen. Yes.
Just like a skirt.
Okay, I will send her here to call Queen Vashti for you immediately.
Thank you.
Where is Hege? Hege. Okay, I will go.
Ah, my king. Oh, my. Every day we keep doing this.
Queen Vashti. Queen Vashti, the fairest of them all. The most beautiful lady in the land. Queen Vashti, can I come into your presence tonight? Queen Vashti. I am from the king. Queen Vashti, the king needs you immediately. He is really in need of your company tonight.
What madness is this? After 7 days of partying, is he okay? I think he's sick. Tell him I cannot come.
Oh no, my majesty, I can't tell that to the king. Please, can you consider your stance again? I can't go and tell him you're not coming.
Don't you understand English?
Go away now.
Please,
Queen Vashti, can you please reconsider?
Go away. Ah, don't do.
King Hazaras.
Yes.
An abomination has been committed.
What is it?
An abomination. Queen Vashti has refused to come to your presence.
What?
She even said you are mad.
No.
She said you are sick.
No. The queen said I am sick.
Yes, I'm sorry to say it.
She said I am sick.
This cannot happen in my kingdom.
It cannot happen because all the men in this land will have no more respect from the women.
No. This cannot happen.
Something just has to be done right away.
We need to meet.
Wise men, what do we do?
It's an abomination. The women will not respect their men in this land anymore. She has refused to listen. She said some words I can't even say.
Deport her.
Okay, that's fair. She's lucky I wasn't the king.
Okay. Wise men, you have spoken well. As king of this kingdom,
yes.
Upon my authority, I decree that Vashti is no longer queen of my kingdom.
Yes.
Let her be removed immediately from her palace.
As you have said it so, it is written. Hege, where is Hege? Hege, Queen Vashti has been deposed. She is no longer the queen. We need to evict her from the palace immediately. And once that is done, you go with the strong men. You take her out because I know she's going to be very naughty. Make sure you evict her and you go around the whole town and call all the pretty ladies, all the virgins, because we need to replace the queen immediately. Is that right? Thank you.
sisters. We know they are coming.
Vashti.
She's your queen, you know. You don't have respect. Hey. Can't you see my crown?
Vashti.
This boy
does not have respect. The king has spoken.
Which king?
The king has spoken. Vashti is no longer the queen of this land.
What do you mean by that?
Speak English.
The king has spoken. Vashti is no longer the queen of this land. So with immediate effect, yeah, to leave this kingdom.
Ah, Vashti has expired.
So Vashti, leave the kingdom now.
Oh, can I what?
Move the camera.
Beauty is not the matter. I think the Lord's favor is on your life. You should run for it.
Okay, Uncle, I will.
You will?
Yes.
Be a good girl.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Splendor.
My name is Joel. Just put my name at the top. My name is Bangiza. My third name is Giza.
Hi, you're looking good. My name is Elizabeth, but you know what? They call me Queen. Queen. And just remember, my name is Libby. So my name is Anastasia, Tasha.
Long live the king. Okay. Are you ready for us?
Yeah, the ladies are ready.
The king is ready to look, see the ladies.
Okay.
I hope they are all virgins.
My king, here comes Splendor. 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 My king, here comes Joel. My king, here comes Giza. Also known as from Gibbs.
People are coming out, she's coming.
Giza. My king, here comes Elizabeth, the queen. My king, here comes Lily. My king, here comes Tasha. And last but not the least, here comes Esther.
Give her space, give her space. Who?
Come.
Fix your thing.
Go faster.
Come on, start
song. Ah.
Oluwa.
Yeah. My king, that's all.
Go,
wise man. What do you think?
Something.
I have chosen.
You've chosen a queen?
Yes, I have chosen a queen. As king of the land,
you have chosen well, sir. I will go and deliver the message to Hege, and Hege will tell the ladies, and they will disperse immediately, and I'll bring the queen to you. Hege, the king has made his choice. We have a queen. Long live the queen.
Thank you.
You please go and wait and take the chosen one to the king.
Many were called. Only one was chosen. The king has spoken. And he chose Esther to be his queen.